I'm Sarah.
And I'm Chris. Today we're testing the ioSafe Solo.
It's an external hard disk drive enclosure designed to withstand catastrophic events. And it's specifically designed to withstand flooding and house fires. So Chris, what did you do?
Well, take a look.
We're gonna do a flood test today. We're submerging in a fountain here to simulate the conditions you would have in a household flood. There you go. So now I'm going to take it back to the lab and see if the hard drive is still readable. As you can see here, we've got some cushioning and a plastic wrap that's enveloped the hard drive. Hard drive looks dry, feels dry. The plastic wrap probably is airtight, and it's probably what contributed to being hopefully watertight. All right, so let's hook it up. We've got a SATA duct right here, which hopefully will connect to our hopefully intact hard drive. There it is. Well, that seemed to work. So next we're gonna go someplace a bit more interesting.
You threw it in a fountain. This is why we don't let Chris around our electronics. So how long can it survive underwater?
Well, the company says it can last for up to 3 days in under 10 feet of water, but we didn't have that time, obviously. But we did get the drive to mount and the file was readable.
So where did you go next?
All right, we're here at Oakland at the Crucible Department of Fire Arts to test the ioSafe's fire retardant capabilities. We're gonna go talk to Peter Crump and see just how toasty we can get this thing to be. Peter, what we got here today?
This is the MS2 portable fire cannon.
Cool, and what kind of fuel does that use?
It's running propane.
And how high is that gonna get today?
It's gonna be about 3,000 degrees.
All right, terrific. We're gonna get this set up and get back to you in a second. Well, it looks pretty charred, and as you can see, the fan pretty much has melted completely. So we're gonna let it cool down, and then we're gonna test it again. Drive looks pretty crispy here. Oh, wow. This is still warm. And it's also very, very wet. As you can see, the flames have melted the fan completely. Sure enough, there's our file. Looks like our hard drive is intact, and I gotta say, the ioSafe is indeed fireproof. So congratulations to them.
Really, guys, do not let him near your electronics. Still, it was pretty cool that it survived all that. But those aren't real house fire conditions.
Well, no, I couldn't actually burn down a real house, Sarah. That's illegal. I was pretty impressed the ioSafe could withstand the conditions we put it under. The ioSafe's ceramic exterior was pretty impressive in that it could release water vapor to cool the unit. I thought that's a pretty cool defense mechanism.
So, despite his best efforts, Chris has yet again failed to destroy expensive electronic equipment.
Thanks for watching.